Welcome everyone. My name is Pramod Beesal. I am an IT Delhi graduate and currently an IRSME officer. In this video, we are going to discuss about the stepper motors, which is the last topic for actuators and sensors in mechatronics part. So a stepper motor, as the name suggests, that it is going to have certain steps for its working or its functioning. Okay, and those steps can be provided in terms of pulses. So we have a pulse driven motor here, and those pulses will be generated with the help of a generator. Okay, so there will be a pulse generator needed to drive a stepper motor. This is also known as a DC brushless motor, and usually they are very low cost motors as compared to the servo motors, and they are open loop circuit based. What do we mean by open loop circuit based? Means there is no feedback or no sensing of the output of the stepper motor. Okay, so we will simply give the command and we will get the output. We do not take care of the output. We do not read out the output whether it is equivalent to the input or not. So there is no feedback system here. So it is an open loop circuit. If we want a feedback system, then we use servo motors. Okay, so those are continuously monitoring motors and also costly in nature because we are having feedback system in them. Fine. So stepper motors are based upon open loop. Now if we go ahead with the classification of a stepper motor, it can be classified into three categories. The three broad categories are: number one, there can be a variable reluctance type stepper motor. Okay, there can be a permanent magnet type stepper motor, and then there can be a hybrid stepper motor. So these classifications are basically depending upon the rotor type only. Okay, so in any motor we have these two components here, two major components basically, and those components are the stator of the rotor, stator of the motor and rotor of the motor. Okay, so stator is, as the name suggests, it is a stationary part or the fixed part, and the rotor is our rotating part, and there will be certain number of windings in our stator which will be carrying the current and generating magnetism, okay, which will in turn attract the teeth or poles of the rotor. Okay, so to better understand the concept, let's start with our variable reluctance type motors here, stepper motors. Fine. In a variable reluctance type motor, we are having a rotor which is made of soft iron. Okay, so it is not a permanent magnet here, it is just a conducting material only. Okay, and on the stator we are having those windings. For example, the example that we are taking here to understand the concept, we will be having certain number of teeth on our rotor. So in this case we are having two teeth, one teeth and two teeth on our rotor, and we'll be having some number of poles on our stator. In this particular case we are having 1, 2, 3, and 4 number of poles onto my stator. Okay, so number of poles and number of teeth will basically guide the full step angle and half step angle. We will be discussing them very soon. Fine. Now when I am having this configuration that I have presented here, okay, let's say there are two phases A and B. So I am having two coils basically, A dash and B B dash for our this motor here. Fine. So what will happen initially, let's say the rotor is in this position, the position that has been shown here. So if I want to draw the logic table here, okay, so I will simply say current in IA, and let's say current here is IB. Okay, so when I am having current in IA and I am having current in IB, what will be my theta or my position of the rotor? Okay, so what will happen initially, that when there is a current in IA, so this current is 1, and there is no current in IB, means current through the coils relating to BB dash is 0. In that particular case, since it is magnetized now, this coil and this coil, they are magnetized, AA dash. So this iron core is going to get aligned along this. Okay, so it is going to get aligned here. So basically it is going to have this rotation. Okay, because they have got magnetized and they will attract this iron core. Okay, so let's call this angle as 90 degree. Initially it was 0 degrees in here when there was no current. So, and when IA was 0, IB was 0, it will be 0 degrees. Now when IA is non-zero, IB is still 0, I will be having a 90 degrees rotation here. Okay, then after, let's say now IA is 0 and I have provided current in IB. Okay, so there is no current in this particular coil, but this coil has energized. So the last position of the rotor was this one here. right? After this, I have energized this coil and de-energized this coil. So since this coil is energized, this rotor will get attracted to this position. Okay, so this is going to be my next position, and let's call that as angle 180 degree. Okay, now I have got 180 degree. Next, what I will do? Now I will energize A dash, means I will just reverse the direction of current in A dash. So finally, I can say that, let's say this is I A dash and this is I B dash. They are same coil only. I'm just representing them in a different way. So when I A dash is energized and there is no current in B, I will be having 270 degrees over here. Okay. And so on, I can calculate the final 360 degrees of the coil over here. Okay. So that is how our system will be working basically. But if you need to draw the logic table here, which is for two phases, so I'm having two phases here, right? What do I mean by two phases? It is basically AA dash and BB dash, two phase system, and two teeth on root. Okay, so it will be, the table will be like this only, A, B and my theta. It will be like when 0, 0, it is 0. When it is 1, 0, it will become 90 degree. When it is 0, 1, it is become 180 degree. And so on, I can draw the logic table. Okay. Now, there is something known as full step angle. And there is something known as half step angle. Okay. So, depending upon our energization of these particular coils, the coil AA dash and BB dash, I will be getting the output in terms of my angle or the position of rotor, right? Theta I will be getting there. So full step is when one coil is energized at one time, when one coil is energized at a time. Okay, so at one time I have energized only one coil, then I will be getting full step. So it, the angle that has been rotated by that full step is known as theta full step or the full step angle. Okay, now half a step is just basically half of full step, so theta fs divided by 2. So I am going to explain the energizing conditions later also, so that you can understand it better, how exactly we can calculate the half step and full step. So when I say theta fs, it is given by the formula theta of the rotor minus theta of stator. Okay, and theta of rotor is nothing but 360 degree divided by number of teeth on the rotor. Okay, theta of stator is nothing but 360 degree divided by number of poles. Okay, so for this particular case that we are doing here, theta fs will be equal to how much? Theta r is how much? Here theta r is 180 degrees and theta s is how much? Theta s is 90 degrees. So my full step angle is 90 degrees. Okay, so when I'm energizing one coil at a time, which was this case, so I am getting 90 degrees of step angle in this case. Okay, so for half angle, it will become 45 degrees. Okay, now let's discuss the working of a permanent magnet stepper motor, and half angle as well as full angle, both operations we are going to see here. Right, so in our permanent magnet stepper motor, we will be having the rotor, which is having a permanent magnetic poles, north pole and south pole, and then we are having the stator. So there can be any number of the stator coils or any number of stator poles that we want to have. In this case, we are having four poles, or I can say two coils or two phases basically. Okay, A dash and B B dash. Now let's see the full step rotation of the rotor as well as half step here. So full step we have already calculated with our formula that it is going to be 90 degrees. Okay, so initially let's say I have energized A dash coil here. Okay, so when I'm energizing my coil A dash, in that particular case, because of the current direction, this south pole is going to get attracted to this side. Okay, because it will become the north here. Okay, so the position of my rotor will become something like this, that south, it has rotated to the upside down, and south has gone up and north has become down, and I can call that as my theta equal to 90 degree. Now the second rotation or the next step that I have is I am going to energize B dash B. Okay, so the direction of the current will be from B dash to B. In that situation, when this is the current position and I have energized B dash to B, so south pole will get attracted to this side. Okay, and now this will again rotate like this, right? So the south pole is going to come on this direction, north pole is going to be on here, and I can call that as a theta equal to 180 degree with respect to our initial position, right? Then again, I will energize this coil, means A dash to A. So A dash to A, this will be attracting my south pole, so it will become upside down, and that I can call as a theta equal to 270 degree, and similarly I can have theta equal to 360 degrees also. That is how we calculate the full step operation in a stepper motor. Okay, now we can represent it with the help of a truth table or the logic table also. Again, as similarly as we did for the variable reluctance. Okay, now here the operation is known as one phase on at one time. Okay, so because we are energizing only single phase at a time, so we are getting a full step operation with the help of one phase on. Now, what will happen if I have two phases on at the same time? Okay, so let's consider the case wherein I am energizing my B and A together. Okay, so both of them are being energized simultaneously, so both of them will attract the magnet here. Okay, so B is also attracting the magnet, A is also attracting the magnet, so final equilibrium position for the magnet is going to be at 45 degrees. Okay, so this will become the magnetic position when A and B both are energized, because this is also attracting and this side is also attracting it. Okay, now what will happen, that next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to energize A and B dash. Okay, so when A and B dash are energized, these two faces are going to attract the magnet. Okay, so it is already in this position. Now I have energized this and this part, so the magnet will rotate from here and it will go to this particular condition. Again, I am having a step of 90 degrees only. Okay, so I am having the step again as 90 degrees. Fine. Then further, if I will be energizing B dash and A dash, then it will be aligning along this particular angle. So that will be the next position for my magnet, right? So this will be south pole and this will be north pole. So again, the step angle here is of 90 degree only. So even if I am applying two phases simultaneously, I am going to get the full step angle operation only. Okay. Now the third type of operation that I can have is alternatively one phase on and then two phase on. Okay, so once I will be having one phase on only, and then I will be having two phase on. Okay, so let's say this is the initial position in which I have made the diagram here. Fine. So what I will do, initially I will energize B and A simultaneously. So I already know that it is going to make an angle of 45 degrees here, right? So there is going to be a 45 degree rotation. From 0 degrees it has reached to 45 degrees, correct? Then I am energizing only A, means B has been switched off, only A is being energized. So this position of the south pole or south north pole is going to get aligned vertical along A dash, right? So that will be my magnetic position. So again, this is theta equal to 90 degrees. So here I am getting a step of 45 degrees. Okay, so initially from 0 to 45, then 45 to 90. Similarly, now 2, then 1, then again if I energize 2 simultaneously, which are A and B dash. So A and B dash, when energized simultaneously, the magnet is going to align along this line. Okay, so that is going to be my angle here, let's say theta equal to 135 degrees. Okay, so here the step angle between two particular steps I am getting is of 45 degrees, which is basically our half a step. Okay, so in order to get a full step, we can have either one phase on or two phase on simultaneously, and in order to get a half step angle, we can have alternatively one phase on and then two phase on. Okay, now the next thing that we are going to discuss is our hybrid stepper motor, which is basically a common hybridization of variable reluctance as well as permanent magnet motor. So what we are doing here is basically that we are having the permanent magnet at the core or as at the rotor, but we have given certain number of teeth to our permanent magnet. Okay, so as I explained, we are having north pole and south pole onto our rotor, and I have divided the teeth such that the two of them are not coinciding with each other. Okay, so whenever I am having a teeth here, let's say this is going to be my north pole. Okay, then there is a space because I have made the teeth out of it, and this is going to be my north pole. Similarly, there are going to be south poles alternately onto this. Okay, so when I look from the side view, okay, there are going to be like these are my south poles here. Okay, I'm not increasing the number of poles, just to clear it out. Okay, so these are my south poles, and the north poles are alternate to them, means there are going to be my north poles over here. Okay, so that is like the basic structure of a permanent magnet in case of our hybrid stepper motor. Okay, so that is how we have a permanent magnet with multiple number of teeth onto a single motor only. Okay, so these are our north poles and south poles. North, south, north, south, north, south, and so on. We will be getting these poles, north, south, north and south. Okay, so what I have done here, that I am using a permanent magnet and I have increased the number of teeth here basically to reduce the size of step angle. How will that help us reducing the size of step angle? That we are going to discuss. Again, we are having these stator windings here. Okay, these are our four stator poles and there are a number of teeth here, and we can again calculate the theta full scale and theta half scale and can have a better results here. Okay, the one thing that we need to know here, that for theta full step or the step angle as we call it, the one formula that we have discussed earlier is theta r minus theta s. Okay, the another formula that we have here is which is known as, okay, so we can be having 360 degree divided by n into m. Okay, so I can have 360 degree divided by n into m, where basically m is the number of poles on my permanent magnet and n is the number of phases. Okay, so what I'm having here is n is the number of phases and m is number of poles. Okay, this is basically on stator, right, and this is on rotor. Okay, so for example, that I am having 15 teeth on one side of permanent this permanent magnet here. Okay, so there are 15 teeth on one side, means I will be having total 15 into 2 teeth on my rotor here. Okay, and let's say I am having two phases of my current, some A and some B, then the theta full scale would be equal to 360 degrees divided by 2, that is the number of phases, into 15 into 2, and that will come out to be how much? 6 degrees. Okay, so that is how it helps us. That is how a hybrid stepper motor helps us to reduce the step angle here. Okay, so that is like the main and basic criteria behind this. Okay, so number of phases is basically number of phases, not necessarily equal to the number of poles onto the stator. Okay, so this is the main formula to calculate theta fs when we are given the number of phases and number of poles. Otherwise we can use theta r and theta s also. Okay, so now if we overall look at the main the positives and the negatives, or the advantages and disadvantages of any particular stepper motor, then there will be, like, the main advantages of a stepper motor are, it is a low cost, it is rugged. Rugged means it is like very rough and tough type of design that we have for stepper motors. It is low maintenance. We don't need much of the maintenance here. It is simple in construction. Okay. And less likely to stall or slip. The chances of it getting stalled or slip are very low as compared to other ones. Then excellent start, stop and reversing response. Its response for start, stop and reversing the direction is very excellent, and it can work in any environment. As we said, that it is very rugged in nature, so it can work in almost every environment, which is not the case with a servo motor. Okay, so disadvantages of a stepper motor, the common ones are the low torque capacity as compared to a DC motor. Okay, so we are having a very low torque capacities here, and we have limited speed. Okay, because if we increase the speed beyond certain limit here, then the slip will start happening. Okay, so we cannot have very very high speeds here. Then vibration and the noise at high speeds will also increase, and synchronization may break at the overloading conditions. If we overload our system, if we overload our motor, then there is a chance that the synchronization between the phases and all those things will break. Okay, so that is like the basic things about any stepper motor. Now let's look at the characteristics of a stepper motor. Okay,